If you plan to attend the Great Minnesota Get-Together this year, be sure to stop by the legislative booths in the Education Building to talk with lawmakers and learn more about a variety of legislative topics. What will fairgoers find at the Senate booth this year?
They're going to find a lot of exciting information on the redistricting process, a process I think a lot of people hear the word, but they don't really know that much about. And so our goal this year is really to help educate people on how they can get involved in such an important but relatively unknown process.
For many years, the Senate has encouraged fairgoers to fill out the opinion poll that asks questions on some of the pressing issues of the day. That opinion poll isn't here this year. Why is that?
We wanted to focus this year on redistricting and what that looks like because it's a long process, it's a complicated process, and again, a process people may not be as familiar with and that they can really engage lawmakers in, and they can engage the process in, I think, a lot more handedly than some other means just of the legislative session and so forth. And so really shaping that conversation, that's so important, but I think underrepresented in Minnesota.
Those who staff the Senate booth this year will presumably be well prepared to answer questions on redistricting. What kinds of questions do you anticipate? What will workers be prepared to answer?
We're going to talk a lot about the timeline, what people can expect of how this process goes forward, what it actually looks like, what does redistricting mean in practice, and then where does this come from? Why do we have to do this process? Why doesn't it just stay the same? Among other things, too, we'll be talking about what actions have been taken, because a lot of people don't know that we have redistricting committees that have already begun to work in the House and the Senate on this issue.
What else can fairgoers find at the Senate booth?
A fun and fabulous time. In addition to information on members, we're going to have Senate members of both parties here. And have them answering questions. People can directly engage with lawmakers and get their thoughts. My goal this year is to help demystify government and make people involved in the process so that going forward, if they have an issue, they don't hesitate to reach out and help make that change.
Next door to the Senate booth, you'll find the display for the House of Representatives. Barry LaGrave, Director of House Public Information, offered a preview of what fairgoers can expect. I understand it was a bit of a challenge to get hold of a ballot box for this year's State Fair opinion poll. Why was that, and how did you eventually secure one?
Well, you're right. It was a challenge because the elections ballot machines are sort of locking them down, so they just want them to be used for their intended official purpose. So we were able to connect up with a company in Omaha. So we shipped up ballot machine up from Omaha. Last week for the fair, they're letting us use the ballot machine, and it's actually one we used in 2019 at the last fair. So it was quite involved, but we really like doing the poll, so it's great to have that.
On this year's opinion poll, what are some of the topics that voters and fairgoers can weigh in on?
We've got 12 questions. We're in the Education Building, so we've got a question about should K-12 students be wearing masks, be required to wear masks. We've got are elections secure in the state? We've got a question about what the legislature's role should be in peacetime emergency determinations. And so a wide variety of questions. We've got a recreational marijuana question. So a wide variety that interests, we hope, all the fairgoers.
In addition to taking the opinion poll, what are some of the other reasons that fairgoers should visit the House booth here in the Education Building?
Well, we do have members scheduled to be at the booth at various times throughout the fair. We've got a computer set up so we can identify for fairgoers their legislative district, House or Senate, congressional district. We've got publications. We have green books, our popular green books. We've got a lot of those, so those are free to anybody that stops by the House booth in the Education Building. And anybody can be the speaker. We've got a plastic gavel in front of the speaker, President Lincoln, and pretend to be the speaker.